जय हिंद डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल टू योर मैथमेटिक्स क्लास। फ्रॉम लास्ट फ्यू लेक्चर्स वी ऑल आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज ऑफ द चैप्टर सम एप्लीकेशन ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद द सेम टुडे ऑल्सो विल डिस्कस सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द एनसीईआरटी बुक एज वेल एज सम अदर इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस from the other books also which are important from our examination point of view. So let us begin with the very first question for the today's class. The first question is a 1.2 meter tall girl spots a balloon moving with the wind with a horizontal line at a height of 88.2 meter from the ground. The angle of elevation of the balloon from the eyes of the girl at any instant is 60 degree. After some time, the angle of elevation reduces to 30 degree. Find the distance traveled by the balloon during that interval. Along with the question, the diagram is given. So the girl is standing at the point where the angle of elevations are mentioned. The height of the girl in this question is given, whereas the total height of the balloon from the ground level is 88.2 meter. We need to find out the total distance traveled by the balloon in that particular interval. So basically we need to find out the distance traveled by the balloon as shown in the figure. Using the same figure, we will be drawing another diagram which makes us more clear about the diagram which is given. So here is the diagram which is just the replica of the given diagram along with the particular labeling. So we have considered that A is the initial position of the balloon, and after some time the position of balloon from A changes to B. So AF is the total height of the balloon from the ground, and also BH is also the total height of the balloon from the ground, that is 88.2 meter. Since the height of the girl is mentioned, so we will take that C is the position of the eye of that girl, and the height of the girl is 1.2 meter, so CD, EF and GH all will have the same measurement, that is 1.2 meter. So if I have to calculate BG, we will subtract 1.2 meter from 88.2 meters so as to get the value of either BG or AE. So with this diagram, we'll move on to the solution of this question. So we will have two different triangles, one is ACE, another is BCG. What basically we need to determine is either EG or FH, you can say any one of them. That is the distance traveled by the balloon during that particular interval when the angle of elevation changes from 60 degree to 30 degree. So let us begin with the first part. We have considered that CD is the girl, FG is the distance traveled by the balloon. It should be EG, the distance traveled by the balloon. Now in triangle ACE, if I take triangle ACE, tan 60 degree is equals to perpendicular by base, that is AE upon CE. Tan 60 is root 3. And now AE can also be written as AF minus EF. AF is 88.2 meter. And EF is 1.2 meter. So we use the same dimensions over here to determine the value of the unknown quantities. So this is how. So the value of CE will be equals to 87 by root 3, which when rationalized gives you 29 root 3. So 29 root 3 is the value of CE. Now proceeding in the same manner, we will go to triangle BCG. And now in triangle BCG, if I apply again the tan theta, so tan 30 will be equals to BG upon CG. Again, BG will be 87, and upon CG, now on simplification this, we will get CG as 87 root 3. So the length or the distance from C to G is 87 root 3, whereas from C to E it is 29 root 3. So if I have to calculate EG or FH, we will simply subtract CE from CG. So when we do that, we will be getting is equals to 58 root 3. So the distance traveled by the balloon in that particular interval is 58 root 3 meter. This is how we need to solve this question. Let us move on to the next question. The second question is, a straight highway leads to the foot of a tower. A man standing at the top of the tower observes a car at an angle of depression of 30 degree, which is approaching the foot of the tower with a uniform speed. After 6 seconds or 6 seconds later, the angle of depression of the car is found to be 60 degree. So we need to find out the time taken by the car to reach the foot of the tower from that particular point. Once again, to solve this one, we require the diagram. So let us consider this two triangles, and since the angle of depression is given, so that topmost is the point from where the man is observing the car. So the angle of elevation depression in the first case is 30 degree, whereas in the second case it will be 60 degree. Now let us label the diagram. Obviously, with the alternate angle property, these two angles will be of 60 degree. And then, once we label the diagram, AB is the tower, D is the initial position of the car. After 6 seconds, the car will reach to the point C. And we have considered that CB distance is X meter, and CD distance as Y meter, and the height as H meter. So now we will apply certain trigonometric ratios to find out the time taken by the car to reach to the foot of the tower, that is to reach point B from point C. We need to find out how much time will the car take to reach from point C to point B. And we know that in moving from D to C, it took 6 seconds. This question can be solved in many ways. There is one way which we have already discussed in the classroom. This is the second method which we are discussing it over here. So the first step is, we have taken the triangle ABC, in that if I use tan 60 degree, that will be equals to H by X from here, or AB by BC. So from here, if I calculate the length of AB, it will be equals to root 3 times BC. Same way, if we consider triangle ABD, there if we apply tan 30 degrees, so we'll be getting AB upon BD. From here, we will get the value of AB as BD upon root 3. From step 1, we got AB as root 3 BC. From step 2, we have got AB is equals to BD by root 3. So if we equate them, we get root 3 times BC is equals to 3 BD upon root 3, and then if we shift that root 3, which means if I shift this root 3 to this side, root 3 into root 3 becomes 3. So 3 times BC is equals to BD. Now this BD can further be written as BC plus CD, so that's what we have written. Now shift this BC to this side, we will be getting 3BC minus BC, that is equals to 2BC is equals to CD, or BC is equals to CD by 2. So we have got that this length is half the length of this. So that's what we have written over here. The distance BC is half of CD. Therefore, since the car is moving with the uniform speed, so the time taken by that car to move from C to B will also be half the time taken by the car in moving from point D to point C. So from point D to point C, it took 6 seconds the car to travel from D to C. So it will take half of 6 seconds, that is 3 seconds, from moving point C to point B. So the final answer is 3 seconds is the total time which the car will take to reach point B from point C. Moving on to the one more question for the today's class. This is an additional question, not from the NCERT, but a good question. So the question says a spherical balloon of radius r subtend an angle theta at the eye of the observer. If the angle of elevation of its center is phi, find the height of the center of the balloon. So here is the diagram. This is the balloon. O is the center, and it is written that it subtends angle theta at the eye of the observer. That means if A is the eye of the observer, then the circle subtends an angle like QAP or PAQ at the center, which will be equals to theta. And the second part says that angle of elevation of its center means from O, if you join A, then angle of elevation is phi. So angle OAB is phi. For the sake of convenience, I have taken the total height, that is OB, of the center of the balloon from the ground as h, and radius is already given that for this particular circle the radius is r. So we have got two triangles, one is OAP, another is OAB. So we use, now there is one theorem. The next chapter which we will be studying is a circle. So in that particular chapter you all will be studying a theorem about the tangent of a circle, which says that if you draw two tangents to a circle from a single point, like from point A we have drawn two tangents AP and AQ, then from the same point if you join the center of that circle, like we have joined O to A, then this line will always bisect this complete angle. So these two angles will have the same measurement. So if the whole angle is theta, the measurement of this part will be half of theta, that is theta by 2. So this is what you need to remember. Now let us begin with the solution. This is what the diagram is. It's all labeled over there. Now, if I take triangle OAP and apply sine theta, so for theta it is theta by 2. So sine theta by 2 is perpendicular by hypotenuse, so it becomes R upon OA. So I have taken OA as a D just to make it more conveniently. So sine theta by 2 is R by 2. We have taken it as equation number 1. Now I'll consider triangle OAB. In that triangle, if I take sine phi, it will be again perpendicular by hypotenuse, that is OB upon OA once again, that is H by R. So we got two equations. Now I divide the second equation by the first. So when we do so, we get sine phi upon sine theta by 2 is equals to H by D upon R by D. Now this D and D will cancel. We actually have to find out H in terms of whatever is given. So in terms of R, theta and phi. So from here we got this is equals to H by R. Now sine is the reciprocal of cosec, or cosec is the reciprocal of sine. So 1 by sine theta by 2 can also be written as cosec theta by 2. And when this R will be shifted to the left hand side, we'll be getting H is equals to R sine phi cosec theta by 2. So the height of the center of this balloon from the ground is R sine phi cosec theta by 2. With this, we come to the end of the today's class. We'll be meeting in the next class. Till then, do solve as many questions as you can and revert back to us if you face any problem. हैप्पी लर्निंग, जय हिंद।